Hey guys, so today's video is a little bit different because I'm going to talk about one of my biggest mistakes that I've done last year running Facebook ads. And I just wanted to share with you guys that everyone is doing mistakes and it's okay. The most important thing is to learn it and just improve yourself. So excited to share with you this and let's get into that. So my mistake was that I wasn't excluding website visitors from the top of the funnel ads, which is very important because your top of the funnel ads, which is basically prospecting, is finding new prospects in your business. And my theory was that Facebook needs to optimize new prospecting ads and they need some kind of warm data. And they are going to show some warm data into for them, and then when they get some sales, Facebook is going to optimize that top of the funnel ads and then start finding new prospects. But what Facebook ended up doing is that when I wasn't excluding any visitors, is basically just targeting warm audience and not finding new prospects, which is bad because top of the funnel goal is not to advertise to your warm audience, but rather advertise to the new audience. So when I started testing this ad account, which is different business than my previous videos, I saw that my ROAS was crazy high and the purchases was super low. The cost per purchase I was paying on average was like $11, and when it should be like $30. The ROAS was like 8, you can see like 39, 5. But yeah, the ROAS was crazy, and the budget was much higher. This is different. I changed the budget because I was doing a lot of testing. So and then I just got like very suspicious because I didn't know what's happening. Like, yeah, I was like happy to get to have these kind of results, but it was super strange because I have never seen those kind of things happening. So I basically find out this with my team help, and we basically come up with a solution. How we can test that, because in this business, when new where completely new customer comes in, he needs to register. So when we have a pixel, we can track those registered people. As you can see, for example, here I have 28 and 38 purchases, but when I go and see how many complete registrations I have, so here's 1 and 4. So 90% of the audience is actually warm, and this ad was working for like a week with like 20% $20 budget. So in this case, most of my let's just see the average results. So for example, in this period of time, in 2 weeks, I got 182 purchases, and only 20 of them was new. So yeah, most of them was warm audience. So basically, at that point, I understand that I'm reaching only warm audience, and I'm doing bad for this business. And when I try to run new ads with excluding 30 days visitors, my ROAS went down from 9-10 to 1-0, and basically I needed to redo my ads and redo my angles and do testing again. So yeah, and this is my one of the biggest mistakes I've done. Now I'm excluding 180 days visitors from all of the ad accounts, all of the ads I run for the top of the funnel. And I'm recommending you guys to do that the same. If you're not doing that, you're doing a big mistake, because it's important to structure your ad account to three different funnels, which is top of the funnel, middle of the funnel, and bottom of the funnel. And also there is a backend. So top of the funnel is actually where all of your scaling happening and where you can scale your ad account. And middle of the funnel and bottom of the funnel is basically remarketing and remarketing to the to your warm audience. So it's crucial to have a good structure and good angle that is working, and you're 100% sure that you're getting those new prospects and not targeting warm audience. So I hope you guys learn something new. I hope you guys, if you're not excluding, please exclude those 180 days visitors from all of your top of the funnel ads, and don't repeat my mistakes. So I hope you learned that. If you're doing that, you're doing an awesome job. Thank you guys for watching, and see you next time. Bye bye.